Now, on an ECG, atrial flutter resembles sawtooth-like F waves. This is the result of an ectopic atrial pacemaker or because of a rapid reentry pathway somewhere within the atria, albeit outside of the SA node area. The origin of this ectopic pacemaker is usually somewhere in the lower atrium and closer to the AV node, thereby resulting in a distinct wave pattern. Due to this erratic electrical activity, the normal function of the SA node is usually suppressed and non-effective. So instead of a P wave, atrial flutter produces flutter or F waves, and as a result of the depolarization of the atria in an abnormal manner. The classic F waves of atrial flutter resemble a sawtooth, hence why we give it that name. Now let's take a little closer look at the ECG. First, we ask ourselves about the rhythm. Is the rhythm regular or irregular? In this case, it's variable depending on the ratio of F waves to the QRS complex. Then we ask ourselves, what is the rate? The rate is variable. Is the rate normal, fast, or slow? In this case, the rate is variable because of its irregularity. So next, we evaluate the P wave. Are they present? Are there anything closely resembling a P wave? Or is it just that sawtooth type F wave? Other P wave questions do not apply when we see the F wave flutter. Then we ask ourselves, is the P to R interval normal, less than 0.20 seconds? And in this case, no, because it's variable and there are no P waves. So now we move on to the QRS complex of the ECG. Is the QRS interval less than 0.09 seconds? The answer is yes. The QRS is within normal range. Then we ask, is the QRS wide or narrow? And in this case, the QRS is narrow. Are the QRS complexes similar in appearance? Then we can see that each one looks similar. So now, what is our cardiac interpretation? Structural heart disease is the usual cause of atrial flutter. It can develop in newborn infants with normal hearts and in children with congenital heart disease, especially after cardiac surgery. In the same way that atrial fibrillation complicates adequate ventricular preload filling, atrial flutter complicates circulation, especially when accompanied by a syndrome called rapid ventricular response. The faster the ventricular response, the more the circulation will be compromised.